Breaking news. Welcome to today's headlines. HIPOP, I will not tolerate smear campaign. Division in fighting. Nnamdi Kanu blows hot. HIPOP, I will not tolerate smear campaign. Division in fighting. Nnamdi Kanu blows hot. To my dear listeners from wherever you're listening from, stay tuned as I read today's news. The leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, HIPOP, Nnamdi Kanu on Tuesday, said he would no longer tolerate a smear campaign against HIPOP and the legal team. The HIPOP lead counsel, Ifeanyi Ejiofo, disclosed this in a statement to newsmen in Owerri after they had visited Kanu at the detention facility of the Department of State Security, the SS, in Abuja last Monday. Kanu said, "Those behind the smear campaign should be seen as traitors." Ejiofo, while quoting Kanu, he said, "Consistent with the subsistence order of the court, we paid a routine visit on Oyedo Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. We availed ourselves of the opportunity afforded by the visit to brief Oyedo on several issues. First, we acquainted him with the level of preparedness for the preliminary skirmishes that will take place in court in the criminal charge preferred against him. As you all know, proceedings in the criminal charge will resume on the 16th instant. Second, we briefed him on the smear campaign orchestrated against my good self by traitors and desperate enemies of the struggle, aimed at causing disharmony within the fold and needlessly generating ill feelings." Oyedo was thoroughly ashamed by the utter infantile mendacity inherent in the smear campaign and the unimpressive, unintelligent, wobbling and poorly thought hard strategy that informed the whole endeavor. He advised that I should quickly ignore and consign the half-hearted attempt of such a despicable lot to the garbage bin and resist every attempt by them to distract me. He was not at all rattled or perturbed by the news of the smear campaign, but rather re-emphasized the unshaken trust and confidence he has always reposed in me. He observed that any true son or daughter of Igboland that opts to take the pleasure of making derogatory or disparaging publications against my good self or any of his older lawyers is guilty of cheap blackmail and must be pitied for condescending to an abysmal level. Such a person must be seen not only as a contemptuous slave, but also an irredeemable traitor to the entire Igbo race. Further, Oyedo warned that he will not tolerate any form of distraction, division, or infighting in his peaceful movement. He commended the dedicated officials at the helm of affairs of the movement for living up to expectation, HIPOP said. The leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, HIPOP Nnamdi Kanu, on Tuesday, said he would no longer tolerate a smear campaign against HIPOP and the legal team. the High Public Council, if you are in a geofall. Disclose this in a statement to newsmen in Owerri after they had visited Kano at the detention facility of the Department of State Security DSS in Abuja last Monday. Kano said those behind the smear campaign should be seen as traitors. Ejiofor, while quoting Kano, he said, consistent with the subsisting order of the court, we paid a written visit on Oyedomasi Nnamdi Kanu. We availed ourselves of the opportunity afforded by the visit to brief Oyedo on several issues. First, we acquainted him with the level of preparedness for the preliminary skirmishes that will take place in court. In the criminal charge preferred against him. As you all know, proceedings in the criminal charge will resume on the 16th Eastern. Second, we briefed him on the smear campaign orchestrated against my good self by traitors and desperate enemies of the struggle, aimed at causing disharmony within the fold and needlessly generating ill feelings. Oyedo was thoroughly ashamed by the utter infantile mendacity inherent in the smear campaign and the unimpressive, unintelligent, wobbling and poorly thought out strategy that informed the whole endeavor. He advised that I quickly ignore and consign the half-hearted attempt of such a despicable lot to the garbage bin and resist every attempt by then to distract me. He was not at all rattled or perturbed by the news of the smear campaign, but rather re-emphasized the unshaken trust and confidence he has always reposed in me. He observed that any true son or daughter of Igboland that opt to take the pleasure of making derogatory or disparaging publications against my good self or any of his older lawyers is guilty of cheap blackmail and must be pitied for condescending to an abysmal level. Such a person must be seen not only as a contemptuous slave, but also as an irredeemable traitor to the entire Igbo race. To my dear listeners, now we've come to the end of our today's news. Please do drop by at the comment section and let us know what your view is all about. Thank you for listening.